What's going on, guys? Cody here with CJ Bill. Thanks for tuning back into the channel. And guys, we're finally able to strap our D16Y8 turbo to the dyno. It is a stock motor, no internal work. The previous owner did do head work. And honestly, I don't think they really torqued the head down to spec because we're already having head lift at 7 PSI. So for the dyno session, unfortunately, we have to lower it to 4 PSI. We're gonna be using a MaxPeedingRods 57AR T3 T4 turbo. Huge shout out to Tracker Performance for letting me go to the dyno for teaching me all the things you're gonna teach me today. Huge shout out to Sixth Street for filming with his crazy camera setup. You'll see the watermark on the videos that he took. He has a wild Supra, check out his channel as well. And shout out to the baby, Challenger Queen, for helping film while I was focusing on tuning. So let's go ahead and get to the dyno session.
Yeah, you're definitely hitting the...
Yeah. I think it was a turn. The last time I tightened it. Do you have a 10 by any chance? Like moving?
I lowered the boost, so when I put it on, it wasn't bad about angle.
No, we were making changes because here it was reading 11, the AFR being at 11, but there he was getting like 10.0, so the car was literally like falling on its face, Rich. So we were going based off that one, and it seems like kind of what he was saying, like the, on that downpipe, it seems like the AFR sensor might be too close and it's, the boost is throwing it off a little bit, because even now we took off like 20% of fuel on top, like in boost, and here it stayed the same, but it's running cleaner. And there he's getting 11 also, so it seems to be an AFR, the gauge. I mean, the O2 sensor isn't picking it up properly, which could be a downpipe thing. Like poor design or just poor location of the O2.
That's like a mechanic, we fix it.
Yeah, that's like, that's something to change in the future. Like when we go to the different, well, we're probably, if we're gonna change manifold, so we'll probably go to the downpipe. So that's just something to note for future reference, like location of the actual O2 sensor being a bit further.
And they're trying to hit their target, I believe that's AFR. And once they hit their target AFR by modifying the volumetric something, then they can adjust the AFR without having to touch the volumetric something map. I'm sure Cody could do a better voiceover, but in case, like, I don't know, you wanted to know.
And let's do 12.5. Let's see if it gives a little bigger change.
I should, in theory, put it for like 12.2.
We're really close. That way we could see if it likes to be richer, leaner, or does it like to be richer?
We'll be right back. Alright guys, well that's the end of the dyno session. The final numbers were 155 and I think 126 torque. It's not a bad number for 4 PSI, but we aren't really chasing numbers. It was a learning experience for me to really be on a dyno for the first time and actually tuning on a dyno. So again, I appreciate Trackout, Six Streets, Challenger Queen, my baby girl, for being out there. If you guys want to see more Honda content, be sure to subscribe. We're going to be doing engine builds and some more Honda stuff. So we'll see you soon.